Well, here we go. We're going to go do, this is part of the prop face-off. We're going to do a time to climb with the MAC prop, and then we're going to switch to the MT. We're going to do the time to climb and the speed run with that. So stick with us on FlyWire. Hey, I'm Scott Perdue, and today on FlyWire, Bob and I are going to take the Bonanza, take Charlie up to do a time to climb run. We already did a speed run. We're going to do a time to climb run with this Big Mac. It's a big, long one. And then we're going to drop it, put the MT on, and we're going to do the same thing. Time to climb, and then a speed run with that. So, stand by. I haven't heard anybody else in the pattern here. Have you?
No.
Make sure prop, throttle go, flap set, cow flap set, trim set. I'm ready. You ready? Portland traffic, Bonanza 33 Charlie is taking the active 17 with a departure to the west, Portland.
Granbury traffic, Sir 184 Papa Mike's crossing midfield, east to west, we'll teardrop back for runway 14, Granbury.
Once I say now, I'm going to release brakes, okay?
Okay.
Now.
Believe it or not, it's actually pretty easy to change the spinner. And the only hard part really is making sure that your prop governor that you have is compatible with the prop you're putting on. And if it is, you're good to go. So undo the prop nuts, use the pretty good torque. So watch out for that. And you're in a pretty confined area, so you don't want to damage the nose ball. And then as you get ready to pull the prop out, you've unloosened it, all the nuts and everything, then you got to prepare for oil. Because it's oil that makes the thing work, so it's going to make a big mess if you're not careful. Then you just pull it out of the crankshaft and put it away. Boom. See? Easy. Peasy. Clean it up your mess, and then we put the new prop on. And it's got eccentric bolt pattern with dowels, so it's pretty much hard to clock it incorrectly. So there you go. Put it on. Torque it down correctly. And then put on the spinner and make sure you get that done. And don't cross thread any screws. And that's pretty much it. Pretty easy peasy, believe it or not. We took 1 hour, just a hair over an hour, 1 hour and 2 minutes, from pulling the airplane in to having it ready to go.
So, mixture, prop, throttle to go, flap set, cow flap set, trim set. We're on traffic, Bonanza 33 Charlie is taking the active 17 with a southwest departure, Portland. Okay, so I'm going to run the prop up and I'm going to say release. I'll say brakes now. When I say now, start your watch. And that's okay. When I release the brakes. Good thrust right off the bat. I mean, it's quite a bit more dig right there.
It's biting now. Air's cool.
Ready, ready. Airborne.
Look at that, 100, 200 feet at least.
All right, for the time to climb, what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave full throttle, manifold pressure, fuel flow, everything the same.
and I'm going to do cruise climb. So we do the same thing for both props. We're just going to turn off to the south here, southwest.
Traffic is RV 2626 Mike, 8 miles west of the field. We'll be crossing over the field and are in a left downwind for runway 17, runway traffic, with Portland traffic.
Coming up on 2000 mark, temperature is 66. Fuel flow is better than 24, 27 inches, 2660 RPM. Yeah.
Okay, well,
climb speed is about 1200 feet per minute. Temperature, 62. Stand by on the time. Ready. Hack climb is 1100 feet per minute. Manifold pressure is 26.5. Fuel flow and RPM, no change. All right. We are on our track. We'll let it stabilize here a little bit, check everything. It's going good. We got everything set right, cal flap set. Got a good cruise. Indicated airspeed is 153, ground speed is 140, and our track is 027. Fourth flight says the wind is from over there. So I think this prop is like 3 knots slower than the Black Mag. Indicated, 191 ground speed.
Still 260.
260, yeah. I'm not going to change that track. All right. Pretty stable, altitude's good. Airspeed's 156, ground speed's 162.
What's it heading?
The new track is 130.
Well, there you have it. I cut out short the video of the climb, most of the climb test, and the triangular course. You've seen one data point, you've seen them all. But I took data points at every 1,000 feet all the way up to 9,000 feet for the climb test. And for the triangular course, I take about 4 to 6 data points across the leg, and each leg of the triangle for me is 10 miles. And then I average those out and then work those into my spreadsheet. So we came up with the climb test, the speed test results, and compared them to the Black Mac. The thing about this version of the spreadsheet is it kind of uses the OAT, cancels out density, altitude, and all that kind of crap, so you don't have to worry about it. The simple version, I posted on my website, to FlyWire's website, it's just simple. It doesn't do all any of that fancy calculations. But I figure you're looking for the data. So the two-blade Black Mac, which is 2A37C223, and it happens to be a brand new prop. I mean, it's got 117 hours on it now. It's really a pretty good performing two-blade prop. It's quite a surprise. And it weighs 4.5 more pounds than the MT does. So that's pretty considerable. The takeoff difference was the Black Mac took 14 seconds to take off, and the MT took 12. okay? That's about a 14%, it's 14% improvement over the Black Mac. And you could feel the thrust, and it felt throughout the takeoff roll like it was grabbing air, it was biting a little bit more, as Bob said. For noise, we due to, you know, there's an app for everything, right? On your iPhone, there's an app available for a decimeter, a decibel meter, and I recorded it, plus we had an outside camera, and we recorded the decibels as the airplane passed by. For the Mac prop, inside, it was 96 decibels for the takeoff, and outside, it was 134 decibels for the takeoff, which is pretty loud. That's almost rock concert loud. For the MT prop, it was 125 decibels. Outside and inside, it was 92 decibels. The interesting thing about that is there's about a 10, call it a 10 decibel difference. That's almost half the noise level different. Okay, so it's 10 points in the decibel scale, works out to be about half the noise level or so. It's pretty impressive. It was quieter. It didn't have quite the slap pitch and that you feel with the Black Mac as it goes by, which is almost a seaplane prop noise. It's pretty loud. Inside, during the climb, the Black Mac posted 107 decibels, which is still pretty on the loud side. It's good to have ANR headsets. And the MT prop inside was 92 decibels. So that was a considerable difference on the inside. And it is orders of magnitude smoother. I don't have my prop balancer. I can't put on the airplane and record when we're flying. Can't do that. Too bad, because the vibration differences were considerable. I mean, it felt, you know, people, the anecdotal is that people say, well, it felt turbine smooth. Well, it does. And it was truly amazing. Big, big difference. So time to climb to 9,000 feet. Same takeoff profile, same power settings, same airspeeds and everything. The Black Mac took 8 minutes and 58 seconds. And the MT was 8 minutes and 44 seconds. Okay, so it's only a 14 second improvement time to climb. And when you look at the data and the individual data points, basically it was the 3,000 to 4,000 foot time frame that was different, because it was almost 1,200 feet per minute for the Black Mac, and it was about 150, 180 feet per minute different for the MT. It was slower. And that's the only one, that segment of data was the only time that the Black Mac outperformed the MT. Throughout it, the rest of every other data point, the MT posted a better time, a better climb rate, but that was a significant one, enough situation to actually affect the whole outcome. And the MT, overall the MT had a 2% advantage over the Mac. So pretty interesting. I don't really recall anything different for that 3,000 to 4,000 foot time block, but it was. And we did the speed run. The MT was 2 knots slower in cruise than the Mac was. And I found that pretty interesting. It's pretty typical for a three-blade prop to be slower in cruise. The big advantage of a three-blade is it absorbs horsepower, and when you really need that is on takeoff. Okay, so you want more thrust on takeoff, you want to be able to absorb more horsepower, and that's when you get the big benefit, is from that and through climb. So the interesting thing, the climb was kind of the same. I mean, not that big a difference. 2% is not that big a difference. So this two-blade Mac is actually a pretty good prop, pretty good performing prop. So anyway, I'm happy with my MT, and I'm fascinated by the design of that blade. So we're going to take a little deeper look at that. So hang on for the video coming up in the future on that. Meanwhile, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. And if you'd like to subscribe, hit that button down here. It kind of looks like this right here. and hit the bell for notifications so you get an idea when the next video comes out. And if you like it, hit like. I appreciate that. That helps me a lot. Subscriptions help too. That helps the whole algorithm thing. And thanks for watching. And we'll see you next time on FlyWire. Click this link for the latest upload. Click this link for whatever YouTube thinks you ought to watch. Or you can click this link to subscribe. Thanks for watching.